Yo guys, what is going on? Welcome back to a brand new episode of WWE Supercard. This is episode 162, and I am happy to announce my internet is back, which means we're going to be doing some streams and finally look straight at my camera pretty much when I'm playing Supercard instead of being on my phone. And it's just, thank God, it's only taken about 2 weeks, but we finally got there. Today I've got a jam-packed episode. We've got so many cards to pro. We've got some team battleground to look at. We've got some team ring domination to look at. So yeah, let's get on with that. So we'll go in team battleground first. We've matched up with a team called Active City. So yeah, let's have a look. Hopefully it'll give me the pack animation again so you guys can see what I'm getting. Probably not, because we're firmly in the prep game at this point. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so this is what I'm rocking. Not the best cards. I only got one WrestleMania. It gave me a Harden, a couple of Elites, three Elites actually. But, you know, it's not the worst I've ever gotten. So my team, some of them are charging, doing okay. With 12 hours left, confident, because I know most of them will put in the grind and get all those charges. Hopefully we can make this win number 14 in a row. Obviously 14-0, that would be awesome. I'd love to make it to 20 and maybe about 20-0, maybe try and beat Undertaker's streak. Obviously it's a bit less significant our streak, but nonetheless that'd be pretty cool. So yeah, ring domination. Now I didn't show you guys any gameplay from ring domination at the first part when we got the WrestleMania Undertaker, of course, because the internet was down. But yeah, I'm gonna play a little bit now. So the ultimate is Brock Lesnar. We're gonna try and get it, I think, just so we can also get some charges and stuff. But I would like to shout out the team and just welcome some new members that we've gotten. So Nick, you are doing well, man. Mao plus Choo Choo equals life. Doing well again there, man. Shout out to you. Fat Boy always puts a grind in the events. Triple H, who is a new member to our team, so hopefully he does well, and he is doing pretty well there on 13 shards. Super JT, been in our team for quite a while now, always does put in the grind, so shout out to you as well. Sabra, one of our longest members with Flame and Fat Boy, so that's pretty awesome. He always gets what he needs to do, always does it, so big shout out to you, Sabra. Flame, what can I say about Flame that hasn't been said already? Absolute legend. Jamie B, new as well, kind of the team, one of Flame's friends. Did well in Team Battleground. We're going to have to see a little bit more from him now for Spore Shard, but we'll see. And then Roman Reigns, another quite new member as well, who's, I just can't see that because for some reason Needroid's cutting the bottom out, but I think he's on 2, maybe 3 shards. So yeah, again, quite new, he has yet to really prove himself, but confident that this team is, it is doing well, so yeah, brilliant. Anyway, let's actually get into some gameplay. I'm not sure how my board is doing, if it's pretty empty or not, but we'll get a couple games in, and then we'll go ahead and pro a couple cards that he's got to pro. I think it's only one card to pro, but it's a pretty good one, and I've actually got a load of stuff to show you guys. I got my Battleground Wars, last Battleground I didn't show you guys, because again, internet was down, so I didn't record that. But I'll show you who it was. Pretty awful reward, I'll let you guys know that. But we will show you who it is. And a load of pros, I've got a lot of pros, a lot of cards to pro. An absolute ton of cards, and we're going to do what actually is more than a couple we can do on the video. So we've got 4 picks. Our board is actually pretty cleared. Hopefully we can get a shard here or some charges. As long as we get one or the other, I'm happy. Okay, well, we got one charge. I think they should add because in wild mode, and I think in solo events, when you get a charge, it will actually show you on the board that you've gotten a charge, but on team events for some reason it doesn't. I think it should, just so you get an idea, because, I don't know, sometimes I'm like, oh, look, what, 4 charges in a row, awesome, have they, increased the drop rate for them, and then I'll play, 2 games and get, 1 or something, so, yeah, I wish you'd get charges more frequently, I think, because, yeah, I think over time, it's going to be going to be quite a pain in the ass having to get all these charges. You know, right now Battleground is new still, it is still kind of fresh, but as soon, you know, time is going to go on, people will soon start getting bored of it, just like every other game mode. It's going to be a tough ask after to get like 120 charges, especially if you don't have the credits to spend on getting the multipliers. So that's just something, maybe it should be different. But anyway, one shard, that's good. We'll take that. Let's see if we can get another one here with our three picks. Charge, I'll take it. Another charge. Can we make this three in a row? We can't, but I'll take it. And we get another shard on Brock. Brock's already a pro, so no catalog there. Really, with the ultimates, it's really winding down to only a couple cards left for me to finish the catalog. That's actually a couple things I want to show you. Now that I'm not worried about my internet just randomly shutting down, I can really show you guys a lot of things that I haven't had the time to show you in the last couple of videos. So that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to go on combinables. There's a lot of exciting things here. We've got the Jinder Mahal. First off, that you know, we got there in the end, the RTG, got the second Jinder. Really excited because, like, this is like his first card in Supercard. It's a cool card as well. I personally quite like Jinder, so I'm happy that I got it. Then we got this insane Goldberg Pro that I'm really happy about. One was the left arrow, and it was fantastic. And then Team Ringdom came out, and I really didn't talk about it too much in my video, but that made a pro for me. Which is, again, so exciting because Undertaker, again, is a left arrow and he's top tier. So is Goldberg. So this Undertaker and Goldberg are going to do wonders for my deck. So is AJ Styles, obviously Jinder. Then we've got Dean Ambrose over here who will make our, like, RTG deck, those kind of things. So we will definitely get him perfect pro'd. He's getting there. We've got a couple more games in toughness. About 20 more games, or 19 more in power, so that will take a little bit of time. This card again, lacking a bit of power, but apart from that, about three quarters of the way there, so that's good. AJ is, again, three quarters of the way done on that one. I think done on that one, so that's good. We've only got one more. This Undertaker's completely done. The other one isn't done at all. Maybe like one game or one stat or something. And then this Goldberg on both of the cards are done, which we're going to pro him in this episode. And then we've got these other cards. We've got Ty Dillinger, who we could pro, but it's not going to be a perfect pro. Can I be bothered to perfect pro him or not? I don't know. I really don't. I don't think it's worth it because he won't make any of my decks. He's a right arrow, not very important. But anyway, guys, sorry. Just give me one second. I'll be right back. Guys, sorry about that, but I'm back. You guys know how it is. The crazy life of living at home with your parents. But anyway, we got some cards to pro. I know people will kind of maybe rage in the comments again. I'm not perfect proing this tie. Look, he's not going to make my deck. I'm doing it just so, you know, we've got him done. He's in the catalog. It's all good because Ty is actually a really bad card. And if I show you real quick my RTG deck, for example, this is what we've got. We've got James Ellsworth still in the deck, which is the worst card in the tier. But then you've got Baron Corbin, because we didn't pro him, just like we're going to do the Ty Dillinger. So maybe he'll just be better. I think Baron Corbin will be better than Ty, though. And at this stage, you're looking at Goldberg added into this, you're looking at Undertaker, you're looking at Jinder, you're looking at Dean Ambrose, you're looking at AJ Styles. That's like five new cards. So obviously, we're going to say goodbye to Ken Shamrock pretty much. So yeah, you know, a Ty Dillinger is when, you know, we can not perfect pro him. So I think that's what we're going to do right now. But yeah, pretty cool. How did we get this tie? He was in the RTG, which made a pro for a lot of people, which is the first time I think that they've put a wrestler, like, this is the second time they've put the same WrestleMania card in an event. They had a tie in a team event, the third or second team event, I think, they had a Ty Dillinger. So this is the first time. They have obviously loads of cards they've missed out on, so it's interesting to see what their system is. But anyway, we're going to go and combine this Ty Dillinger. Yes, we're sure. Both level 50, obviously, so it's going to be a gold star. But obviously, it could be better if we have got the games played on the second Ty Dillinger that we got. So let's move on with Xavier Woods, which is quite exciting as well because it's his catalogue for me. You know how excited I am for catalogue stuff, so that's pretty cool. Get that done. We got actually a third Dean Ambrose. So as I mentioned, I've still got the Bailey down there. We have pulled a Dean Ambrose since, and I keep forgetting, but hopefully by the next video, I'll have Dean Ambrose instead of Bailey. He is my last pull. Now I'm going to show you who we got for my battleground. Last battleground that I didn't record, as I said, awful, awful reward. Well, I didn't actually say awful that many times, but it was complete trash. We got a single James Ellsworth, worst Cullen tier, already got a pro of him. Literally the worst thing I could have gotten. So, yeah, not too sure what to say about that. I'm quite happy I didn't actually record that because it would have been awful. And we got the Xavier Woods, which made the pro from those rewards as well, if you're wondering when I pulled that Xavier Woods. But time for the exciting part, and that is this Goldberg, a perfect pro Goldberg. Going to be one of my best cards for a long, long time, obviously below the event cards, but he's going to be really up there until the next tier, obviously, because he's so good in the tier, he's not going to get removed from any deck. So that's awesome. Well, not any deck, sorry. I mean, like, Ringdom he'll be in for a little while at least, and then, obviously, RTG. So anyway, let's get him pro'd. Just, again, making sure you know how it is. All tokens used, level 50, 40 in all stats. Because it would be a damn shame if we were to mispro this Goldberg. But we're going to go ahead and combine him right now. There is Goldberg. Perfect pro'd. Get in. Alright, that means, yeah, we're literally going to be working on Jinder Undertaker. This Jinder card is all done. So we're just going to be working on the other one. And then I'll probably keep AJ, maybe Dean, especially Dean, till probably the next Team RTG. So just chuck him in there. And then just really focus on, like, Undertaker. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video. It's been actually a really, really long video. Not too much gameplay, but a lot of, like, combining, proing cards, which is important. We're going to have a quick look at the catalogue with our WrestleMania cards. We are doing well. Like, AJ will be proed, as you can see. We're missing, obviously, a lot of Divas. Brian Kendrick, actually, which is probably the only, like, really low-down card in the tier that I haven't got a pro of yet. Brock Lesnar would be awesome to get a pro. Then a lot of females, you know, a lot of females. Dean Ambrose will get pro. There's Goldberg. Jinder obviously will be. John Cena is the only male with Roman Reigns. Sorry, yeah. Roman Reigns, John Cena are the only WrestleMania superstars I haven't gotten yet. As you can see, there's that Roman. So interesting to see how long it will be until I get one of those or until I can complete this WrestleMania catalogue. There are cards, obviously, that I'll never get, like The Undertaker. Like the Mojo Rally that's over here. But apart from that, and you know, maybe Austin Aries, maybe not Alexa Bliss. But yeah, it's going to be really exciting because it looks like we can do really well. And then obviously the ultimate, I mean, what can I say? Look at this. AJ's done, Alexa, both Alexas, Oscar, Baron Corbin, Bayley, Becky, Big Cass. We're looking for one more Big E, one more Bobby Roode. Obviously Braun I can never get, Bray I can never get. Their Money in the Bank cards, apart from that, they're all done. Brett's done. Brock Money in the Bank isn't. All Money in the Banks aren't, but everything else is pretty much done. We're missing a Dana Brooke. Never got her. Nikki Bella's another one. But yeah, Goldberg will never get either. But look at all of this. Just completed. Kevin Owens again, Money in the Bank. Lita I could get. Mankind I could. Those are like the two throwbacks I missed out on. If they bring in WrestleMania throwbacks, we'll have a chance of getting those. Yeah, and then Nikki Bella. That's pretty much it, guys. But yeah, that's awesome. Thank you for watching this episode. Do drop a like if you've enjoyed it. I'll try and get some streams in over the next couple of days if I'm not working. The weather has been awful recently in Switzerland. So as you guys know, if it's awful weather, I'm not going to be really working. So I'm going to try and get some streams out for you guys. Remember, Great Balls of Fire is the deadline from when I can start streaming on YouTube again. It's funny how it is literally the same day. But it is, yeah, the day of Great Balls of Fire is a deck and start streaming on YouTube again, obviously from that 90-day kind of ban or something. But anyway, do drop a like. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care, guys. Most importantly, peace out.